SpaceX says it is on track to send a third group of working Starlink satellites into sun-synchronous orbit as early as 2:40 p.m. Starlink 3-3, which is the third launch of Group Shell 3 satellites, is likely to be the first of many launches from the West Coast. It will be the booster's 10th launch overall. Want to know more about it? Then stay tuned till the end of the video. SpaceX says it's on track to launch a third batch of operational Starlink satellites to sun-synchronous orbit as early as 2:40 p.m. PDT, Friday, August the 12th. SpaceX's launch on Friday was its 36th mission of 2022. The company keeps breaking its own records for the number of flights and the number of times it reuses boosters. If Group 3-3 lifts off on time, SpaceX will have an average of one launch every 6.22 days this year. It was SpaceX's third launch of the month, and they had four more planned for the rest of August. SpaceX has been able to launch a lot of times because it can reuse the first stage of its Falcon 9 rockets. SpaceX used the B-106110 booster, which was on its 10th flight, for the Group 3-3 mission. B-1061 is one of the older boosters in SpaceX's fleet, which is always growing. It has already been part of a number of important missions. Its first mission was the Crew 1 launch in November 2020, which sent the Crew Dragon Resilience into space on the first commercial crew mission that was fully operational. It then flew the Crew 2 mission before switching to unmanned launches with SXM-8, CRS-23, and IXPE before its first Starlink mission, Group 4-7, in February of 2022. With Friday's launch, B-1061 is the fifth booster in SpaceX's fleet to have flown 10 times. Since its first flight, it has taken the booster 635 days to reach this point, making it the third fastest of the five to do so. So far, B-1060 has been the fastest. It made its 10th flight 567 days after its first flight, and now it has flown 13 times. Since its last mission, which was flown from Cape Canaveral on the East Coast, it has taken SpaceX 55 days to turn B-1061 around. B-1061 landed on the drone ship Just Read the Instructions after the Global Star FM-15 mission. Once the booster was back on land, it was taken across the country to Vandenberg Space Force Base. B-1061 joins B-1063 and B-1071 as the three active boosters on the West Coast. B-1049 and B-1051 were moved to VSFB for their 10th and 11th flights, respectively, in 2021. SpaceX wants to increase the number of launches from Vandenberg, so moving B-1061 makes it possible to fly more missions. B-1071 is currently assigned to the SDA Tranche 0 Flight 1 mission, which is set to launch in September. While B-1071 waits for its flight, B-1061 and B-1063 will be able to help with Starlink missions. After getting to Vandenberg, B-1061 started getting ready for the launch of Starlink Group 3-3. Inside SpaceX's hangar at Space Launch Complex 4E, its second stage and payload were put on the Strongback Transporter Erector. A day before launch, the Falcon 9 stack was rolled out to the launch pad. In February of 2018, the Tintin A and B test satellites were sent into space. This was the first step in getting the constellation up and running. Since then, they have put into orbital shells 1, 2, 3, and 4, a total of 3,009 more satellites. With the launch of Group 3-3, there will be 3,055 Starlink satellites in space. Shell 1, which has a 550-kilometer orbit with an inclination of 53 degrees, was only launched from Florida 28 times. Shells 2, 3, and 4 all have satellites that were launched from Vandenberg, but most of the satellites in Shell 4 were launched from Florida. Shell 3 has a 560-kilometer orbit with an inclination of 97.6 degrees. The launch on Thursday is the third mission to put something in Shell 3. Both of the first launches to the shell happened last month. On July 10th, Starlink Group 3-1 took off, and on July 12th, Group 3-2 did the same. With these two launches, 92 of the 348 satellites that were supposed to be sent to Shell 3 have already been sent. Group 3-3 sent out 46 more satellites, making it a total of 138. In September of 2021, SpaceX sent 51 satellites on the Group 21 mission. It is still the only Shell 2 launch as of August of 2022. Shell 5 hasn't started taking off yet, but it will use the same orbit as Shell 3, but with different planes. Shell 5 will likely be sent into space from Vandenberg. Like in other VSFB Starlink missions, the first stage of Friday's mission on the Autonomous Spaceport Drone Ship, ASDS, Of Course I Still Love You, OCISLY. On August 9th, OCISLY left port with the tug Scorpius and moved about 636 kilometers away from the launch site. 2 days later, GoQuest left to help the drone ship, and NRC Quest will be in charge of getting the rocket's payload fairing back. At T20 minutes, the second stage's RP-1 load is done, and 4 minutes later, the LOX load starts. 7 minutes before launch, the nine Merlin 1D engines on the first stage of the rocket start heating up. LOX is used to cool the engines so that there are no thermal shocks when the cryogenic oxidizer flows into the engines at ignition. This is called engine chill. At T4 minutes and 30 seconds, the TE moves back to its 77.5 degree launch position. 2 minutes before launch, the last bit of propellant is added. With 1 minute left on the clock, two big things happen. First, the countdown is taken over by the flight computers, which start up. Second, the tanks of Falcon 9 start to fill with enough air for flight. At T-45 seconds, the LD gives the last go for launch. At T-3 seconds, the nine engines of the first stage are told to start up. A second later, the engine started up and did one last check of their health. Once it's clear that the engines are in good shape and putting out full thrust, the hydraulic hold-on clamps will release, letting Falcon 9 take off. Shortly after launch, the vehicle starts a pitch maneuver and sets itself up on the right azimuth to reach an orbit with an inclination of 97.6 degrees. 1 minute and 12 seconds into its flight, Falcon 9 gets to the area of maximum dynamic pressure. Max Q is the point at which the vehicle's aerodynamic stress is at its highest. At 2 minutes and 32 seconds into the flight, the nine engines of the first stage stopped working. After 3 seconds, the first stage and the second stage split apart. A few seconds after the stages separate, the single Merlin vacuum engine on stage 2 starts up. While the second stage and the Starlink satellites continue to move into orbit, B1061 starts its trip back to Earth. The booster's four titanium grid fins open up soon after it separates from the rocket. After a 4 minute coast, three of the nine engines on the stage fire up for an 18 second entry burn. This burn helps protect the stage as it goes back into the atmosphere. After another short coast, a single first stage engine starts its third and final burn. This last burn, which is also called the landing burn, slows down the stage so that it can land gently on the deck of OCISLY. This was the 136th time that a Falcon 9 had landed successfully, and the 62nd time in a row. While the first stage is doing entry and landing, the second stage keeps doing its main job, which is to put the payload into orbit. Just after the stage separates, the payload fairing comes off. This is the first time the 46 Starlink satellites can see space. To get to an elliptical low Earth parking orbit, the MVAC engine has to run for 6 minutes. Once the second stage is in its first parking orbit, it stays there for about 46 minutes. After this coasting phase is over, the engine is turned back on for a short 1 second burn to reach a 321 by 308 kilometer orbit with an inclination of 97.6 degrees. After another short coast, the stage starts to spin on purpose, and the Starlink satellites move away from it. After the spacecraft is separated from the second stage will do a third and final burn to take itself out of orbit. In the next few weeks, the Starlink satellites will finish their tests in space and move up to their operational orbit of 540 kilometers. Starlink Group 3 is the third of up to 7 missions planned for August. Next up are 2 Starlink missions. On August 16th, Group 427 will fly on B10629 from SLC 40. And on August 24th, Group 423 will fly on B10676 from LC 39A. The B10637 and B10692 boosters will be used to send up the Starlink groups 34 and 420 in August. So that's all for today's video. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up, and if you want to watch more videos like this one, hit the subscribe button and turn on notifications so that you will always be notified.